Welcome to the Feversham Weekly Assembly. Today, we are going to be celebrating a great person from our school who might no longer be with us, but her memory and her thoughts and her smile radiates our entire school. So you'll notice that I'm stood here outside next to a bench. And this bench is quite significant because this bench was the bench that Toomey used to love to sit on. So we thought we'd start off our assembly this morning, myself and Mr. Lindley, on the bench, sir, socially distant sitting. So shall we take a seat, sir? Okay. So this assembly is going to be entirely dedicated to Toomey. And Toomey was such a big personality. Wherever she went, she filled the room. I remember seeing her many times in the entrance, even in the days when she wasn't very well, and she would always smile, no matter what was happening, no matter how much pain she was in, she would always smile, and she would spread that smile to others around her. It was contagious, absolutely contagious. So this morning, we're going to sit on the same bench that Toomey used to sit on, and hopefully this is a little reminder, and moving forward, we will be creating some long-lasting memory for Toomey at school. That will be planned and that will be shared with everybody later on. Okay, so Mr. Lindley, starting off with you today, sir, your words of wisdom.
Not so much words of wisdom, but more words of comfort. The day we fear as our last is but the birthday of eternity.
Wow. Gosh, that is profound, Mr. Lindley. Say that again slowly so we can capture it.
The day that we fear as our last is but the birthday of eternity.
Eternity, wow. You know, that's really quite deep.
That applies
deep.
To all fear.
Yeah, that's quite deep, sir. Quite deep, because actually what makes us human is not just our bodies, it's our thoughts, it's what we leave behind, it's all of our spiritual side that we have, and that lives on. The memories live on, the thoughts live on, and the places that we inhabited, they are kind of filled with our presence. Brilliant. That is really deep. Really deep. Okay, so this morning we're going to be sharing some tributes from the whole school, from the staff, about Toomey. But before we do that, we're going to take our route on a little journey up to Toomey's classroom, and we're going to talk to somebody who knows Toomey really, really, really well. Okay, so. You, Mr. Lindley.
Right.
Okay. Let's just pause here. I remember Toomey used to be here, and she used to stay with her friends here, and she was the center of this place, actually. Whenever she was here, every time I walked past, she would always smile and she would always call me. And she had this iPad, and towards the end, she was communicating through the iPad. And it was always very positive. And that's one thing I think we should remember from Toomey's life, that she was always very positive and always smiling. And that's one thing. I mean, this morning, I spoke to a number of people and I said, what is it that you remember about Toomey? And they all said her smile. Her smile was just infectious and it was everywhere. And she loved singing. She loved dancing, so she really was the life and soul of her class. So let's go. Okay, do you, sir? No. Okay, guys, we're going to go to Miss Castle. I'm going to talk to somebody who knows her really well. Okay. Thank you, Miss. Right, we're in year six. Nice. We're in year six, guys, and these are the who've come into school. And they sat in a social distance way. Okay, guys, we say hello to everybody. You're on. This is a live Feversham assembly. Okay, guys, you've come upstairs, miss, because we wanted to come to Miss Classroom and maybe talk a little bit about, to me, to the people who knew her the best.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, so, Miss Reyes, would you like to say a few words about to me?
Obviously, I only talked to me from September in year six, but I did come across her in other year groups throughout my time at Feversham. But the one thing I am going to say to you all about Toomey is she was just a unique child. Every child is unique, but Toomey was clever. I mean, Mrs. Tarrick and I had a bit of a sort out of books yesterday up here, and we found her books from September, and her handwriting was just absolutely fantastic. She was involved in music clubs with Mr. Rotherham, so she played the drum. Anna can vouch for that because I think she's put a tribute together saying that she was a fantastic drummer. Toomey loved to sing and dance, and her smile, her laughter is the thing that I think we're going to miss the most. She loved to play jokes, not just on the children but the adults as well. And you'll hear some more of my tributes to her later on in the assembly, I'm thinking. It's been really emotional coming into school because the news of Toomey came to me in the holidays. And I think because we weren't in the building, it was different. The way I accepted that, it's been so hard because we've got photos of her everywhere. So there's one of the whole class down there. But then when we walk into the area where she worked with Miss Beebe, there's her artwork on display. We've got photos of her. And it's the incidents I've had with her, which she laughed about, with the lift.
Yeah.
There were a number of times when I kept saying, do I need a license to push your wheelchair to me? Because we got stuck in the lift once. I got to me in and I couldn't get in. Her wheelchair was in reclining mode. So when we managed to get in, I couldn't press the buttons. To press the lift to take us down. When we got downstairs, I couldn't open the door, so I was shouting for help. She was pressing every button on her communication device. But it's those little memories that I've got that I think I'm going to cherish forever, and I think it's the same for all the children. They were all really close. And one thing I'm going to say is I'm so proud of all of Year 6 children in the way that they helped support to me. They played with her, they talked to her, they joined in with her silliness at times, and I think that's what makes their friendship really close. And I'm so proud of each and every single one of them. Thank you.
Brilliant. Thank you. Thank you, Miss Reyes. Thank you very much. I mean, I'll just add one thing to that. That is that to me, towards the last year, she wasn't very well, but she would insist on coming into school. Yeah, whereas she, right till the last moment, she wanted to come into school and she wanted to be with friends. She was such a social person, and I think that is something we can learn from her, that, you know, no matter how difficult life was, she always looked at on the bright side. She was always happy, she was always smiling. And I remember now, obviously, I used to walk past, she used to be in the entrance, and never once did I see her not smile. She was always happy and smiling, and she insisted on coming into school, even though it was difficult for her to sit down, it was difficult for her to stay for that period. But she wanted to come into school to be with her friends. And I think that's such a really powerful thing for us about community, about friendship, about loyalty, and about how we get through things by being together. And I think about friendship. And I think that's a really important message for about Toomey, that the friendship, she was such a powerful person in terms of friendships. She didn't let go right till the end. And I remember towards the end we were discussing little trips for her, and she insisted that her friends come to her for her birthday party. She insisted, and she organized a birthday party for her friends, and they all went there. And that's really, really amazing, that even towards the time where she had other things on her mind, she still never forgot her friends, and she insisted on calling them all. And whatever she did, she always asked for her friends.
She did.
Always asked for her friends.
She did, Miss Dupree. The other thing I also want to mention is, on the day of the bowling party, because that's where she wanted a party at Bradford Bowling, instead of having photos taken with her friends, she used Miss Beebe's camera to take photos of her friends. And I think the fact that she's not in front of the camera, she's behind the camera, it makes those photographs even more special. So as a school, I've spoken to all of Year 6. I've asked them for their ideas as well. We would like to do something a bit bigger to remember Toomey, and I want the children to be involved as well.
Yeah. And I just want to add one thing to what Miss Reyes has said, how all of the children in Year 6 and the whole school community supported Toomey through her last days, and everybody was there. And I particularly want to mention a few people. Miss Reyes yourself, you know, you have very close contact with her. Miss Hussein in the office and Miss Ali in the office, they supported Toomey and her family right till the very end.
They did. Can I just say that Mrs. Ali and Miss Hussein have gone over and above their professional duties in supporting Toomey, but not just Toomey, her family as well. And I'm going to say that Mrs. Ali was lucky. She went to see Toomey the day before she passed away. And I've got that regret that I didn't make my phone call that week to speak to Toomey. So I think that's going to stay with me. But for Mrs. Ali, there's no words to say thank you to her. And I know that the family absolutely have appreciated everything that Mrs. Ali's done for the family, Mrs. Hussein, and the school. And they've said a big thank you in a message that Mrs. Ali has.
Brilliant.
But, yeah. And if anybody has got any suggestions on what we could do as a whole community to celebrate Toomey's life, then please let the office know, let myself know, let your children know, they can bring the messages to us.
Brilliant. Thank you, Miss Reyes.
Oh, thank you.
And wouldn't you like to say anything, guys? Anybody? Oh, you're all so focused on your learning this morning. We can't be distracted. Can't be distracted. I know some of you have done a tribute, which we're going to see later on in the video, so that's absolutely fine. Guys, lovely to see you all. And hope you enjoyed the rest of your day. So we're going to carry on now. Okay. Is Mr. Rotherham with us? Mr. Rotherham, are you with us? Is Mr. Rotherham with us? Okay, that's fine. Okay, that's fine. So guys, today the rest of the assembly is going to be all about Toomey, and we have some tributes from children, from the staff about Toomey. So we're going to hand over to Mr. Hassan, who is going to share those tributes in a moment. Okay, Mr. Hassan, that's over to you, sir. So before we go then, I just want to summarize. We are celebrating Toomey's life. You know, there are certain things in life, you know, where we look at the positives. And I think the positive of this is that Toomey has left some great memories. She's left her personality around school and her values. And I think that's something that lives on. You know, the person might disappear physically, but their values live on. And we've talked about her values, about friendship, about smiling through difficulties. And I think it's such an important message at this time during the COVID-19 period, that these are such important messages. And you wouldn't have thought that Toomey was going through any difficulties if you met with her. Even towards her last days, she was so happy. You couldn't tell. You could not tell. And that's how she lived her life. And I think that is the core value that we should be emulating and spreading that. And the smile. Yeah, the smiling is contagious. I think smiling is something that allows us to get through this life. Okay, guys, so thank you very much. I'll pass over to the tributes and we shall see you next week.
Hello, Feversham family. This is a message from Miss Armstrong in memoriam for Toomey. It was really special that Toomey was in my first class as a teacher at Feversham, and she really did bring so much joy. I always remember how she used to make all the children race her, because she had such long legs that could beat anyone, and she was just fantastically competitive, caring, and a real joy to be around. And I'm sure that everyone will have these great memories. And I just wanted to read one of my favourite poems, which I've slightly adapted, by W.H. Auden. Stop all the clocks, cut off the telephone, prevent the dog from barking with a juicy bone, silence the pianos, and with muffled drum, bring out the coffin, let the mourners come. Let aeroplanes circle moaning overhead, scribbling on the sky the message, she is dead. Put great bows round the white necks of the public doves, let the traffic policemen wear cotton gloves. She was our north, our south, our east, our west, our working week and our Sunday rest, our noon, our midnight, our talk, our song. We thought that love would last forever. We were wrong. The stars aren't wanted now. Put out everyone. Pack up the moon and dismantle the sun. Pour away the ocean and sweep up the wood. For nothing now can ever come good. We miss you, Timmy, so much. And we hope that you're resting in a really good place now.
Some poetry chosen by Miss Johnston. Feel no guilt in laughter. She'd know how much you care. Feel no sorrow in a smile that she is not here to share. You cannot grieve forever. She would not want you to. She'd hope that you could carry on the way you always do. So talk about the good times and the way you showed you cared. The days you spent together, all the happiness you shared. Let memories surround you. A word someone may say will suddenly recapture a time, an hour, a day that brings her back as clearly as though she were still here and fills you with the feeling that she is always near. For if you keep those moments, you will never be apart, and she will live forever locked safely within your heart.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Samina Khan, and I want to read something for Tommy. Up in the sky, somewhere very high, a shiny star, Tommy, is resting in peace. Cheeky smile, great sense of humour, full of joy, full of life. An amazing girl has gone away. It's sure to say she is in heavenly gardens, playing and singing. No more tears, no more pain. Happiness all the way. It saddens my heart that I will never see or hear her again. But she is peaceful, and that is a worthy gain. Tommy used to say to me, "Mrs. Khan, go and do some work. This is out of my comfort zone." I did this for Tommy because I really wanted to do something special for her.
Thank you.
to me. It's been a privilege having you in my class for such a short time. No day was the same. Every day different. Yet the one thing that was the same was your smile, your laugh, and that cheekiness. You pranked me, you pranked your friends, but not once did anybody mind. You'll be missed forever. The words in this poem that I'm going to share seem to reflect upon what you were like and the void that you have left in our lives to me. You meant so much to all of us. You were special, and that's no lie. You brightened up the darkest day and the cloudiest sky. Your smile alone warmed hearts. Your laugh was like music to hear. I would give absolutely anything to have you well and standing near. Not a second passes when you're not on our minds. We love, your love, we will never forget. The hurt will ease in time. Many tears I have seen and cried, they've all poured out like rain. I know that you are happy now and no longer in any pain. Wherever you are to me, you can now rest, and you'll forever remain in our thoughts and prayers. Goodbye to me.
Hello girls, boys, teachers, community, it's Mr. Iqbal here. One of the sad pieces of news that we've had over the last couple of weeks has been hearing about Tommy's passing. It's been lovely to read some of the prayers and the messages, the reflections. And of course, lots of us will be thinking at this time about Tommy, and we'll have her in our heart and in our minds. And it's not always easy when a child dies. As a society, we tend to think of death as something that happens when we're much older. But as Muslims and Christians, we are told to prepare for death at any point, and you know, it can happen when we are young or it can happen when we're old. It does surprise us. We perhaps are not as prepared when death happens when it's a young child, and this forces us to reflect, and sometimes leads us to ask questions that don't always have an answer. When I was quite young, I discovered, somewhat accidentally, that I also, in fact, had an older brother who had died. And this was something that was never really spoken about. My parents never spoke about it their entire lives. And the picture that I have of my brother is a picture of him in school uniform, so he obviously was old enough to be at school, and suddenly he was no longer in my parents' lives, or my life for that matter, because here's somebody who is my brother, clearly related to me, and who died as a child. Even today, there's a gap. He's my brother, and I care about him, as a many of you will feel the gap. You will miss Tommy. She's left a space behind. But I do hope it's something that we can think of in a positive way. And as Muslims and Christians, and as people of faith, we are encouraged to prepare, to pray, and to speak positively about those who are no longer with us. What I would like to do is I'd like to share a poem, and whilst the poem doesn't answer all the questions, I hope it allows some of us to understand that God has a better plan for us all. The saddest goodbye. When God calls our children to dwell with him above, we mortals sometimes question the wisdom of this love. For no heartache compares with the death of one small child who does so much to make our world seem wonderful and mild. Instead of always calling the aged to his fold, God sometimes picks a special rosebud before it's tired and old. God knows how much we need them, and so he takes but few to make the land of heaven more beautiful to view. Believing this is difficult, still somehow we must try. The saddest word that people say will always be goodbye. So when a little child departs, we who are left behind must realize God loves children as angels are hard to find.